Hello, this is Victor bringing here a new Blast from the Past or look to an old book. And this time I want to share with you the Witch Hunter. So this was the first codex where we have ever seen Sisters of Battle. No, we had something in second edition, so this was the codex, I think was on fourth edition at this moment, or third edition, I don't remember exactly. I think it was between the third and fourth edition. Was in 2003. I think 2003 is when this book was launched. So here we have, I want to show you what we used to have. As you can see, they were soft cover, not very thick, was 63 pages, and this was the cover in second edition. Okay, I don't have the book from second edition, so I will show you what was in the third edition. So it was called the Witch Hunters, so it had more than just Sisters of Battles, and as you can see, was focused on the Inquisition, the Ordo Hereticus. Okay, here we have very nice picture of the Army of Sisters of Battle. Curious to see this terrain is quite on some parts a little bit flat. And all the terrain normally we used to have in these books was a scratch view. So, as you will see, we have here we have first an introduction, okay, what is the Ordo Hereticus and how was the Ecclesiarchy and the Ordo Hereticus, who are the Adeptus Sororitas, okay, but we also have the Radicals versus the Puritans, so we had also here something. Some discussions about or some background about the Inquisition and the Inquisitors. Very John Blanche type of illustrations here. Okay, I like a lot these ones. And you can see that all the illustrations and all these pages are in black and white. So we did not used to have full color codexes in that period of time. Due to this organization and of the Sororitas, again, here very 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 nice artwork, but it's again in tones of grays. Okay, we have here this Ancelestine again, but there are more. Then we have the Castigator and not Castigator, painting engine, and we have here different units from the Sisters of Battles. Here we have, we start with now with the powers. So we have the Ordo Hereticus Secret Powers that you were able to buy. Then we have the Inquisitorial Henchmen. Okay. And the different henchmen that you were able to pick. So normally the profile was generic, and then here you had some special abilities of human depending on which type of henchmen were you taking. Here we have some drawings of how these type of henchmen can look like. Okay, and then they talk about the Sisters of Battles with all the special rules. That moment, yeah, we had very specific acts of faith for each type of unit. Okay, so if I'm not wrong, I think this was. No, this was generic and was not dedicated to the type of unit, but these ones you had to roll, so roll equal or under current number of models in the squad. Some you had to go under, and some ones you have to roll over. So some were more dedicated for units and some were more dedicated for characters. Okay, and here we have explanation of the water gear of Adeptus Sororitas. Okay, so you can see that in the past the things were more mixed, so we had rules and also background mixed together. So here we have the armory used to be bigger in the past, witch hunters, vehicle upgrades, witch hunter army list. So now we go to the army list, and you have each time. So when you need to buy equipment, you have to go back. This was the pain, right? But you were able to buy equipment, and then you go up, back and forth. So you can see that there were a lot of war gear things. and then weapons were more limited as they are today. Yeah, and so what units we used to have? So we have as HQ, we had the Ordo Hereticus Inquisitor Lord that you only can take 0 or 1, so maximum 1. Okay, we had the Adeptus Sororitas Heroine, and we used to have the Canoness and the Palatine, and then we had the Priest. Okay, and we did not have the special characters were after. Okay, so here we see, so priests are confessors, missionaries, and preachers. Then as elite we have the Ordo Hereticus Inquisitor. So okay, this was the Ordo Hereticus Inquisitor Lord, so this was the big guy, and this was the small Inquisitor. Okay, we have the Arc of Flagellum, Celestian Squad, and the Sisters of Repentia. And the Mistress was part of the Sisters of Repentia squad. We also had the Officio Assassinorum Operative, and then we had the big assassins, right? The Culexus, the Calidus, the Iversor, and the Vindicare. So the fourth assassins were also part of this codex. Now you can take it as operative for your army, but you can see. Then we have the Death Cult Assassins. Okay, the transports, so Rhino, Chimera, and Land Rider. So you can see we used to have a Land Rider, but the transport Land Rider was more because we have the Inquisitor Lord, and the Inquisitor Lord always had the possibility to go in a Land Rider. And Chimera, because we also had the Inquisitorial Stormtroopers, right? And we had some type of the henchmen that are also a type of they can go into Chimera, right? The henchmen. So as a truth, we used to have the Battle Sisters Squad and the Inquisitorial Stormtroopers. Okay. So these are the elite part of the Imperial Guard. And at first of that, we used to have the Seraphine and the Dominion Squad. And then Heavy Support, Retributor Squad, Immolator, Exorcist, Penitent Engines, and Orbital Strike. But the Immolator, if I'm not wrong, I think you were able also to take it as a transport option. So let me check here how this was working. Yeah, you can take it as a transport option, and then it was not counting as a heavy support. So you do have two possibilities. So you take it as a heavy support, or you take it as a transport. Okay. This only can go in a Rhino. And I think this one. Dominions must be mounted in a transport vehicle. They must be a Rhino costing 50 points. See, transport, or if the squad number is 6 or less, it may be mounted in an Immolator, as you can see here. Okay? And then we have the units. We had as well one scenario in this codex, and then the adversaries of the Witch Hunter. So, the type of missions and things that are what they fight against. Okay, and it's curious here, if you want to make it very fluffy, we have here rules to put the Psychic Apocalypse, the Rock Psyker, the Apostate Cardinal, Mutants, Traitors. So this was really to make a very thematic battle of Sisters of Battles against Heretics. Okay, which had Witch Hunter narratives. Okay, so more on the background. So, and then we have here the special characters. And this, you in that moment of time, you had to ask permission to your opponent to be able to use them. And we have the Inquisitor Lord Karamazov, Saint Celestine. And that's all. We did not have, we still, in that moment, we did not have the Jacobus or the, what it's called. Okay, the interesting thing here is that these characters were not, and the point is quite stupid, right? 201. Wonder there is something, I guess, from that. So what I wanted to say is that in that period of time we were not using too much the special characters. As you can see, they do this work with expensive 200, but you need to ask permission to your opponent to be able to use them. And most of the people did not bother to use special characters. What was very common is to use some of the special characters to proxy your general of the army. Although in that case it was quite difficult because we had San Celestine and we had as well Inquisitor Lord Karamazov, what are quite different. You can see the Karamazov was in this walking throne. This is why he has ballistic and he has toughness 5, strength 6, and have 4 wounds. One thing that I want to show you is that in that period of time, okay, the cannoness, you were able to spend, there were a limit of points, but you were able to spend some points on equipment. Okay, so it is a ruin. Team might be accompanied by a squadron. Okay, no. So if you go here, okay, I think the limit was 100 points in when it's a cannoness or something like that, and you were able to take a jump pack if you wanted. Okay, because this was limited to number, jump pack was limited to number 3, and 3 is adeptus cedulitas heroines only. So you were able to make your own cannoness on with jump packs that is not existing today. This was one of the plans that they had at the moment on time, but at the end, yeah, the conversion did not progress because it disappeared later on. And then at the end we had collecting witch hunters. It's a little bit of showcase of the miniatures. So here we have a Sisters of Battle with a routine of henchmen and the Inquisitor. Here we have, you will also had rules to combine Sisters of Battle with Imperial Guard, so you were able to combine armies with them. Because there was a rule that you can take, I think was up to 25% of them on them, or 50%, something like that, using Witch Hunter allies, in keeping the many possibilities of the forces of the Order Eticus to peer with the Space Marines and Imperial Witch Hunters units can, so you can include them as allies for the next codexes. They include Imperial Guard, no allies. Okay, so you can put them allies with Demon Hunters and blah blah blah. And I think then you were able to ally them with Imperial Guard. Here is the induced, the inducted Imperial Guard or allied Space Marines agents. Inducted Imperial Guard, these are the main elements of the Imperial Regiment requisitioned on Inquisitorial authority. Yeah, but here is not telling me how to put the inducted Guard. There were a point to put inducted Imperial Guard. So you were able to ally them with other forces of Imperium. But it was very strange at the moment in time because nobody, was the this and the Demon Hunters the only armies able to go together with other armies of Imperium. It was very different than today. That's just let me show now the paint jobs. Here we have the paint jobs. So here we see two examples of armies. And then we have here, this was a box that they launched. Okay, it was all metal. I'm regretting that I did not buy this box when it was available. Then we have the four assassins. These are the old versions in metal. You can see that the mirrors today are much dynamic and nicer, but did not change that much neither in terms of design. Here we have a painted engine, an arc of flagellum. Where we see more pictures of the Sisters of Battle, so this is really big pictures. And this was the all San Celestine, sorry. This is the awesome Celestial. We can see quick change. This is was the Immolator, the Rhino. So they already had the new chassis. And here we have some ideas to do conversions, especially for the henchmen. Okay, so this is a Bretonian lady. You can convert her in fanatic range. So okay. So you see this, I think it's another Bretonian, no, it's someone with Bretonian parts. Very, very curious conversions. This is a servitor, and then here we have a paint job of the painting Inquisition with different hairs that you can do on hair, different armor colors, different clothes. Very, very, very top lines. So here we have then the organization of the Soritas, and we have the different orders militant, okay? So the Martyr Lady, the Valorous Hair, the Bloody Rose, Sacred Rose, Ebon Chalice, and Argent Shroud. Okay, and then we have the non-militant orders and the Spitalier, for example, it was non-militant. Militant order. Okay, and then we have painting systems of battles as well. Here some tips on how to paint them. Again, the colors were the very old colors that we used to use. For the face, we use tanned flesh and base coat followed by a layer of dwarf flesh. Okay. And then we have here some examples. So this is some examples of armies of distance of battle with other. And these are some conversions I like about this one. Okay. And here we see some small dioramas and so on. And the drawing from John Blanche. So this is what you have in this Sisters of Battle from 2003. And this was, I think, third edition is still between third and fourth edition, okay? And yeah, and that's all what I want to share here. I hope you find this one interesting. Please let me know what do you think, and it's always for me interesting to see how the miniatures have evolved and how the armies. I will say Sisters of Battle, the first design was quite good after time, right? Is it still looking quite nice? To the point that what Game Workshop did is just a little bit of modernization, but they have not changed too much the design. I would say it's not like the Dark Elder that have changed a lot. Or I would say even the Orcs have changed quite importantly the design from this period of time. So that's all what I want to share here. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please give a like if you have liked it. Share if you think other people can be interested. And as usual, thanks a lot for watching and see you later. Bye.